And the Grammy goes to LA Stand Up, Igor and Tyler, the Creator.
Hello.
With Tyler's Grammy win a few weeks ago, it made me think how much he really grew over the last decade. There are a handful of artists that I've followed since my early teens till now, and one of those artists is Tyler. When I say growing up, I don't really mean any negative connotation to this statement. It is simply something that we all go through. I personally carried some attributes like music taste, etc. over my years of growing up, but left things behind like certain attitude attributes and certain fashion tastes. Like I said, everyone goes through this, but analyzing musicians growing up becomes much more interesting. When in the spotlight, every action and everything you say is pretty much documented. Not only this, but a lot of their changing tastes and attitude is reflected by their music. As artists change, their style and music does too. Regarding Tyler, it is quite crazy seeing how much he's changed throughout his attitude and music, but at the same time, he holds many of his core traits as I once remember through 2011 Tyler. Through Tyler's darker times, he founded characters like Wolf Haley and Dr. TC, both means of expression through his darker times. Through the formation and successes of Odd Future brought us the Odd Future tapes, lettered with infamous lyrics regarding misogyny and homophobia, which gave Odd Future its shock factor. Headlining articles bashing Tyler and Odd Future's lyrics brought them more and more popularity and weariness of wanting to know who Tyler really was, leading to the music video Yonkers off of Goblin, the infamous revolting video of Tyler eating a cockroach with soulless black eyes. Negative attention was good for Tyler, eventually popularizing Yonkers enough to be his first mainstream single and gaining an MTV award. Tyler played on the ideology of free speech by mentioning the murders of Bruno Mars and B.O.B., yet having no real intention of actually committing these. Nobody could really get him in trouble, as in reality he was just a depressed artist, mostly expressing lyrics upon the absence of his father. Tyler claimed that his lyrics didn't really mean anything, they're simply just words, expressing that he wanted to just make old white people mad with the things that he said.
Okay, now what about your lyrics?
What about them?
What are you saying in your lyrics?
Nothing. Shit to piss old white people off like you.
Is that right?
Regarding the theme of this video, growing up, I do not think that Tyler's lyrics were too obscure, considering that he was around 18 or 19 years old when he was recording this. In reality, like he said, he was just saying what he wanted to. 2 years later, as Tyler evolved, so did his interests. He claimed that talking about rape and cutting bodies up just doesn't interest him anymore. What interests him is making weird hippie music for people to get high to. With Wolf, he wanted to brag a little more, talk about money and buying stuff, but not like any other rapper, he was a smartass about it. He said that he couldn't really make his first album again, because he was 18 then, he was unbelievably broke. It's his third album, he has money and he's hanging out with his idols, he can't really rap about the same stuff. Wolf was the first album that I physically purchased on release. I do think that the jump from Goblin to Wolf was very important to Tyler's career. Tyler left most of his excessive derogatory lyrics behind with Goblin and Bastard, but he did not leave his therapist Dr. TC or Wolf Haley behind. The instrumentals over his new adventure of Tyler through a Wolf created an amazing concept album. This set of growth could be classified as becoming an adult, falling in and out of love. Tyler explores heartbreak through Answer and I Fucking Hate You in a much different way than he once did in Goblin and Bastard. Even skateboarding legend and founder of Fucking Awesome plays around with Tyler in a voicemail in the beginning of Rusty.
Grow up, don't go down, grow out. Like if you go from being a kid, just doing your thing, hanging out with your friends. Months later, you're world famous. You're gay rights activist, you don't even know it. You know what? I don't want to say to you no more, Tyler. Fuck you, Tyler.
From what I take from it, Tyler is flying high. He doesn't really realize the influence that he creates and the role model that he is, especially with the statement, months later, you're world famous. Acting as a mention from a friend to be more mindful and realize where you are from someone who has seen it all. Much of Tyler's self-realization with growing up is found in Rusty itself.
Analog fans are getting sick of the rain. All the Tron Cap fans are getting sick of the lakes.
Where he realizes he can't really please all of his fans. Wolf was an introduction to what Tyler was capable of commercially, creating within an actual studio versus his first laptop. It was an essential step to his growth, and he indefinitely wouldn't be here without it. Regarding Cherry Bomb, I didn't give it much light myself, but one thing that was clear is that Tyler reached a new level of happiness, creating what he wants when he wants, bringing a whole new level of sporadic beats, and finally jumping out of his dark ego into the big bright world. Buffalo acts like the Rusty butt of Cherry Bomb, It explores controversy, dropping the same derogatory words that he once did in the past. He addresses this in the beginning of the album to set the tone of explicitly leaving baggage behind. Tyler is inspired by himself, asking how many leaders are in the house, where he pokes at the reality of how many awful role models possess the same fame as him. Tyler expresses himself by making him visible in a room. The liveliness, jumping, and overall uncontrollable when he's happy is seen within his concerts. The loud, abrasive production, intentionally made, is to reflect a childlike sense of freedom and happiness throughout Cherry Bomb. What I loved about Flower Boy is that it embodies Tyler's core values, just brought out in a very easy way to learn more about Tyler. These ways are through growth and expression. In Flower Boy, Tyler reaches his final turn to the man that he wanted to be. Also through the lyric, in the Flower Boy A Conversation interview, Tyler talks about how he had issues growing up with this.
It's a similar thing, tell these black kids they can be who they are, dude. Were you saying that to you? You're saying that to like the people?
Well, I was saying that to, me too, but like it's no one saying that kids that look like me, or to anyone that looks like me. We had this conversation just wanting this snowboard when I was 12, but yeah. Someone saying, oh, that's white people shit. Black people don't do that.
Yeah.
No, you don't do that. Don't put a damper on me and tell me what I can and can't be just because of the way everyone else was. That's my same color. And I just feel like
you are like
wanted to tell them, like, no, be you. Be,
who you are, you know, is such the alternative.
This theme is pretty common throughout Odd Future and not fitting in, producing the persona of Odd Future being a bunch of misfits. Throughout the rest of the album, Tyler further recognizes his influence as a role model and uses his freedom of expression as inspiration. But the real embodiment of expression is especially seen on Garden Shed, where he hints that he's coming out of the closet, being openly gay. This makes the album even more important to Tyler's self-growth and expression. This is especially important for Tyler since he's been hinting this quite frequently ever since he jumped into fame, through various drawings, tweets, and lyrics. And then came Igor, and the realization of becoming who he always wanted to be. But being who you want to be comes with its faults, like falling out of relationships and friendships, which Tyler expresses throughout the album. The album further plays on Tyler's self-realization and expression, specifically regarding love. Although Tyler's love has been covered similarly in a few of his other songs, Tyler has never really taken dedication to speak about love like this. He brings us on the adventure of his heartbreak, and what makes Igor beautiful is that the production confidently holds Tyler's chaotic manner. Through the change from Wolf Haley to Igor, it's hard not to see the growth that Tyler has made. Maturity through artists is beautiful, and as I mentioned in the beginning, it's because every single move is documented. Although I do miss parts of old Tyler, many of his better traits carried on to become the artist he is today. As listeners, it's important to realize that artists grow, just like us. We can't expect Tyler or any other artist to talk about the same material over an entire decade, and if they did, it would become pretty old. The way that Tyler grew highly benefited himself and his career, not only earning him a Grammy, but growing his fan base immensely, and fully expanding his clothing line through getting a deal with Converse, ultimately becoming the greatest version of himself, which is something that we can all take note from. Thank you guys for watching, and I wanted to hear from you guys what your favorite era of Tyler is. Please drop a like down below, and until next time, guys.